I love using Illustrator, my Wacom tablet, for hand lettering, artwork and design. So today I'm sharing with you 5 things to remember for hand lettering in Illustrator with a Wacom tablet. What is up, people? Hope your day is going well. I just passed 2,000 subscribers, which is a huge deal to me. I put a lot of time and effort into my videos, and to know that over 2,000 people want to watch them on a regular basis is amazing. I now upload 6 times a week, which can be tough, especially considering that I have graphic design work aside from YouTube. So thanks again to all of my viewers and subscribers. I'll try my best to keep my content solid and on point for you guys. Kickstart things off today with 5 things to remember for hand lettering in Illustrator with the Wacom tablet. I'm showing you the pressure setting in the brush settings of Adobe Illustrator. I do have a pretty brief but all around good look at Wacom tablet brush settings in a past video, which I'm going to link in the description below. You can check that out after watching this video. But here I want to bring your attention to the pressure settings in Illustrator. If we open up the brush settings window and double click the brush that we're using, you will find these settings open here. In the first category, if we change the settings to pressure and adjust them like so, the more pressure we apply with our Wacom pen, the more the nib will rotate. With the second option, if you put the pressure up, our stroke will go from somewhat thin to round depending on the amount of pressure we apply. And the last setting, which is the one I use the most, with little force used upon your pen, you would get a small stroke, but as you apply more pressure, the stroke will increase in size. Utilising these settings can really help to boost the quality of your hand lettering. When you have some hand lettering complete in Illustrator, you may very well be happy with it. However, you can edit the style and the shape and the size of your hand lettering in detail, outlining the stroke. So select all of your hand lettering in Illustrator, and then go up to Object, Path, and then Outline Stroke. This will open the door to a huge scope of editing and enhancing your hand lettering in Illustrator. After you've outlined the stroke of your hand lettering in Illustrator, you can take the Direct Selection tool, aka the White Arrow tool, and go in and edit your anchor points, changing the style and the shape of your hand lettering. If there are way too many anchor points that make it almost impossible for you to edit it properly, select your hand lettering and then go up to Object, Path, and Simplify. You shouldn't be afraid to use guides when hand lettering in Illustrator with a Wacom tablet. When people learn to write in cursive style on paper, they often use lines across the page. You can do the same to keep everything neat and uniform. Hit Command R or Control R on a PC, bring up the rulers, and then drag them from the top or from the left. My last thing to remember for hand lettering in Illustrator with the Wacom tablet is practice. I do not consider myself a great hand lettering designer, I'm simply okay. Like with anything in life, the more effort and time you put into it, the better you will become, and the more refined your skills are going to be. So maybe spend 30 minutes or so every single day writing out letters or words and draw inspiration from designs online. So let me know in the comment section below or by liking this video if you enjoyed my 5 things to remember when hand lettering Illustrator with a Wacom tablet. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.